Wheat has a strong history in Canada. Roughly 96% of Canadian wheat is produced in Western Canada. Wheat is a very large part of the Canadian economy with export sales of roughly $8 billion annually. I'm Richard Cuthbert. I'm a spring wheat breeder at Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada based in Swift Current, Saskatchewan. We're here to make farmers more competitive in the global marketplace. We're here to increase their productivity through our research. We do that by producing cultivars that reduce their business risk.
I'm Harpinder Singh Randhawa. I'm a spring wheat breeder here at Lethbridge Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada Research Centre. There are a few diseases that are quite a bit important in Western Canada from wheat standpoint of view. One is the fusarium head blight, and another one is stripe rust. We try to breed genetic resistance for these diseases. We incorporate different sources of resistance into our new cultivar. The pathogen at the same time mutate and changes, so we have to continuously breed for resistance.
My name is Brian Beres, and I'm a research scientist here at Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada. Farming is such a complex endeavor that on the same farm you can have multiple issues that will change from year to year. If it's dynamic on the farm, we have to respond with dynamic research.
Of all the wheat varieties grown on the prairies, approximately 70% have been bred by Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada. We're developing varieties with better nutrient use and water use efficiency, and varieties that have resistance to economic pests such as wheat stem sawfly and orange wheat blossom midge.
My name is Garth Patterson. I'm the Executive Director of the Western Grains Research Foundation. We're directed by Western Canadian farmers and funded by Western Canadian farmers. We provide about $8 million a year to Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada, as well as the Western Canadian Agriculture Universities, to support variety development.
Studies have shown that in wheat research, for every dollar invested, there's a net return of $20 to farmers.
Bottom line is to get new improved varieties of wheat out in the field, and through those partnerships that's actually provided almost 200 varieties since 1995.
The future of wheat in Canada is very bright. We have a number of new tools at our disposal, such as the DNA sequence, and we're using that to incorporate new traits into wheat, which will help farmers boost their productivity.